it is. St. John Family Dairy. Y'all can see how he kept this place so safe.
The fence keeps them out?
You betcha. They fry like bugs in a zapper. We're pushing 4,000 volts through that thing with generators and amps.
I'm going to assume that's a lot.
Ever have any accidents?
Nah.
It's safer here than out there.
This place looks untouched. You never know, the rest of the world is in ruins.
It's worth protecting. Hence all the juice.
I thought I saw y'all with company coming down the drive.
Guys, this is our mama.
I'm Brenda St. John, and welcome to the St. John Dairy.
This here's Lee. He's from Macon.
A couple of our old farmhands were from Macon. They grow them good there.
They got a few more friends staying at the old motel.
Oh, my goodness. That place is pretty vulnerable. Have you got someone with survival experience to lead your group?
We all work together. Plus, we've got plenty of people with military experience.
Well, that's good to hear. That motel ain't the safest place.
Hold on. I thought you said someone else was running things.
Oh, yeah. I thought she was asking about survival tactics.
Well, it don't matter. You're here now. We'll make sure you're safe and comfortable.
Thanks for having us. We brought some gasoline on good faith.
We're all incredibly hungry.
These are for y'all. Baked fresh this morning.
Amazing.
Can't get stuff like that anymore. Not without a cow for milk and butter, that's for sure.
That's right. Hopefully Maybelle will make it through this bout of whatever she's got and be with us for a good long while.
Your cow is sick? What's she...
We have a vet. We could bring her here. We can help you folks out.
A vet? Oh, my! Our prayers have been answered.
Maybe our whole group could come for the day.
Well, how about this? Y'all go get your veterinary friend and I'll prepare some dinner. A big feast for all you hungry souls. It'll be nice to have some folks to help out around here again. Danny, why don't you come help me out in the kitchen?
Why don't I head back with the food and round up everyone for the trip over here?
Might want to take someone with you. Remember, those roads can be dangerous.
I can handle myself.
Take this. Why don't you go ahead and take Ben along anyway?
Take care of yourself, Lee. See you in a while.
Mark, Lee, why don't you take a look around? Once you get settled in, I could use some help securing the perimeter.
Is there a problem?
Sometimes the dead get tangled up in the fence before they fry and end up knocking over a post. It'd be a big help if you could walk the perimeter. You can learn a little something about our fence. I'm gonna go top off the generators before they run dry. Come get me when you're ready.
You betcha. This place is incredible. It's got food. And that fence? Oh man, that fence. If we play our cards right, this might turn out to be a place we can stay. So how do you want to play this?
They're offering us food. We should do whatever we can to make these people like us.
The way Brenda was talking, I get the feeling like she'd be happy to have us stay.
All the more reason for us not to fuck this up. If Andy needs some help securing the perimeter, then that's what we do.
So what's your read on Andy so far? Think they'd be open to letting us stay?
Getting the perimeter secured is going to help us a lot.
We'll be getting in good and making this place safer for us.
I'm going to get back to it. Too bad it's broken. I'll bet Clementine and Duck would have loved something like this to play on.
Kids used to like that old swing even more than the tour sometimes.
I'll bet. Mind if I fix it?
Sure, that'd be great. Mama sure does appreciate y'all helping out.
Looks like it just needs a new board for the seat and some rope. Make it safe for Clem and Duck. And let the St. Johns know we can pull our weight around here. Something to cut it down to size. This might make a good seat for the swing. Mind if I use one of these boards?
Already making some repairs, huh? I like a guy who takes some initiative. Yeah, go right ahead.
This fence is fantastic. We'll do whatever you want to help keep it running.
Well, clearing that perimeter is going to be a big help. Just let me know when you're ready.
There, Lee. What can I do for you, sweetie?
Can I help you with anything around the house?
I think with Danny's help, I've got things pretty well squared away in the kitchen. But feel free to check with Andy. He's got a lot of weight on his shoulders these days, so I'm sure he'd love any help he can get.
Your family's done an amazing job of keeping this place up.
Well, now aren't you sweet? Thank you, Lee. The boys and I have tried to adapt as best we can, but we still keep some of our old routines to help remind us of better times.
Well, if anything comes up that I can help with, feel free to let me know.
Well, Lee, I sure appreciate it.
No problem. Good, but I need some rope. The board is good, but I need some rope. I'm gonna need some rope, but that board I found is too long. I'm gonna need some rope, but that board I found is too long.
Well, I'm glad you guys decided to help us out. I noticed back in the motel that you folks are pretty well armed. You've been stockpiling, huh?
Yeah, if you need some extra people to protect the dairy, you can count on us.
Well, hopefully it'll never come to that, but thanks.
Mark and I can help you with that perimeter now.
Oh, good. The fence will stop a walker in about 3 or 4 seconds, but it's overloaded if we leave the husks out there.
You know, Mark and I can clear the fence ourselves if you want to stay here and finish up with the generators.
Well, that'd be great. I'll turn off the northwest section, and you guys could strip them off and look for any weak points. Well, that'd be a big help.
Sounds easy enough.
Stay attentive. You never know.
Think we're doing enough to get the St. John's to like us?
Well, we don't want to seem over-anxious. Showing them we can handle this fence is going to go a long way.
I can't wait until everyone's out here. Everyone besides Larry.
Why the hell did you have to tell him I thought he was a racist? As if tensions weren't high enough.
Sorry, man. It popped out. I mean, you did admit it right to his face.
I try to be civil, at least.
He's too busy being cranky to notice. There's one. Ugh. Lee, it's dead.
Come on, let's push it off.
Andy said when this fence is working, the walkers go up like a tree branch on a power line. If those lights are out, that means the fence is off, right?
It better be. Looks like he's stuck.
Who do you think he was?
Maybe a farmhand. I don't know. I hope he wasn't like this long before the fence finished him off.
Yeah.
Looks like he's stuck. Come on, I'm sure there's still a few more.
Once this fence is patched up, this place will be a fortress. God, can you imagine not having to worry about the walkers anymore?
A fortress needs people to defend it.
We've got enough people. So what's your take on the brothers? They seem to have this place tied down pretty well.
These folks are just delaying the inevitable. This place is gonna fall apart, just like everywhere else.
Maybe you're right.
There's another one.
I see it. Never get used to the smell, do you?
Nope.
Christ. I can't stop thinking about dinner. Would have been nice to get some of those rations. I get hungry too, you know.
Just try to focus on the task.
They knew what they were doing, teasing us with food and then giving us chores.
Having a good meal will be worth it.
Come on, I think I see where they're getting in. This one must have knocked it over trying to get through. He's tangled up in there pretty good.
Come on, help me get this thing back in place so we can get Mr. Crispy off of here.
I think we'd get better leverage from the other side.
Good idea.
Little help here, Lee?
If you're waiting for that guy to help, it ain't gonna happen. Come on. Come on, Lee. We don't have all day.
Holy fuck! What just happened?
The fences are on.
Why the hell would he turn the fence on? He knows we're out here. What the?
Get to the gate! Get down!
You asshole! Jesus! We had to breathe! Now you fuck!
Who the fuck is that?
No idea!
Fuck! Now what?
With a fence on, that gate is our only way out!
You got lucky that time!
Get down!
Did you really think you got stuck with us?
We don't mean any harm, goddammit!
You asshole! Give us the food! Come on out! What about our arrangement? Damn! I see him! Get closer! You fuck with us! Now we'll take what we want!
Lee, hurry up.
You assholes deserve to die.
Lee, get back here.
The blades are stuck in the dirt.
Holy fuck! What just happened?
The fences are on.
Why the hell would he turn the fence on? He knows we're out here.
What the? Get to the gate! Get down!
You asshole! Jesus! We had to breathe! Now you fuck!
Who the fuck is that?
No idea!
Fuck! Now what?
With a fence on, that gate is our only way out! No fuel.
You got lucky that time. You asshole.
Shit, something's still blocking it.
Quick,
we had to breathe it. Hell, you fuck.
Come on, we can reach the gate. We can get through this fence and back to the house.
Ah, shit, that hurts.
Can't hide forever.
What happened?
Shit. It's one of the dead we pushed down earlier. Gonna have to move.
Get out of the open.
What about all the racists? I see ya. Where do you think you're going? Give us the food. Look there. Where's that food you
want? Another one? How many of those things did we push down?
There's a goddamn ambush out there.
Holy shit, are you okay?
Bandits here? On our property?
Oh, my lord. What happened to you, sweetheart?
It was those bastards in the woods, mama.
Yeah, I'll be all right once it's out. God damn, it hurts.
Hey, y'all.
Mark, oh my god, what happened?
He got shot with an arrow.
Christ, are you gonna be okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I should just pull it out.
Oh, no, honey. Come on. Brenda's got you. Come on inside now. We'll have you all sorted out. Well, you must be the veterinarian.
What kind of shit is this?
We ran into some people on the way up here. Bandits, I guess. I think it was them that attacked us.
They gave us a lot of problems in the beginning. Killed a bunch of our farmhand. We were able to get them to stop by making a deal.
You knew about these people?
Food for protection. Not like we had much of a choice, but they did stop hassling us.
God damn it. Carly said this place was locked down tight.
Maybe it isn't as safe here as we thought.
Look, we're sorry. We never had them screw with us like this. Not since we started giving them food. Listen, we may have had an agreement with those people, but we will not stand for this shit.
Ain't no way we're gonna let those sons of bitches get away with this.
You know where these assholes are?
They're hard to pin down, but I think I know where at least one of their camps are. When you're ready to go scope out that bandit camp, come find us.
Bandits? Are you serious? This place isn't safe. We can't stay here.
Not safe? This place is a hell of a lot safer than that motor inn. I think all of us and our guns can handle a couple of punks with bows and arrows. What we need to do is find a way to get our whole group out here to stay. Take this place over if we have to.
Whoa, cool your jets there, Rambo. These are nice people. Let's not do anything to get us thrown out before we eat.
I'm gonna head out and help Dan deal with these bandits. You guys should try to make friends with Andy and Brenda while I'm gone.
Well, that's easy. I got charm coming out of my ass.
Yeah, that's real charming, Dad.
Where's Ben and Carly?
Since Carly and Ben ate some of the food on the way to get us, she volunteered to stay behind and watch the motor inn until we get back.
Hey, I remember seeing kids in your group, so I went ahead and fixed that swing while you were out. I hope your kids like swings.
A swing. I love swings. Just like at my treehouse. Come on, Doc.
Why don't you kids go and play on the swing, huh?
Yeah.
Thanks.
Anytime. We're looking out for you.
That thing keeps a fence around. I guess Mark and I were lucky we weren't touching this thing when it came on. Looks like a feeding station for the cow. If there's not enough room in the house for all of us, I guess a few of us could camp out here in shifts. If there's not enough room in the house for all of us, I guess a few of us could camp out here in shifts.
Lee, oh my God, I'm so glad you two didn't get killed out there. Do you think Mark will be okay?
Wish I knew, but I think he's in good hands now.
Yeah? It's not too bad?
He'll be fine. I've seen guys go through worse.
How could you all bring us to this place?
I take it you and Kenny didn't exactly make up on the way here.
I tried seeing things from his point of view, having a wife and kid and everything. But gambling with your family's life is pretty stupid, if you ask me. Hey, thanks for backing me up this morning at the motel. I know I came down on you guys pretty hard, but you do agree with the way I'm running things, right?
You're a good leader, Lily. Kenny's too emotional, but his intentions are in the right place. Still, it'd be best for all of us if you two could try to work together once in a while. Hey, can I talk to you in private for a second?
Okay.
It's been 3 months. Your dad still treats me like I'm some kind of asshole.
Yeah, well, don't expect that to change. That's just how he is.
Does he treat you like that, too?
Look, my dad can be an ass sometimes, I know that. But he's not a bad guy. He's got a lot of pain. He's been through so much, and lost pretty much everything. And it's hardened him, you know? Yeah, he's bitter and hateful, but that's all just to protect himself. And me. All he's got left in the world is me. And that goes both ways. So yeah, he's probably gonna keep treating you like crap, but that's just because he still has one thing left to care about. So don't judge him. Don't judge me for sticking by him. He's my dad, and I love him.
Think our little arrangement with them was a good idea?
A little late to be asking that now, don't you think?
Dad's right. Let's just wait for dinner. And then if Mark is feeling up to it, we leave. I don't want to push our luck here.
Now, let's not be hasty.
I'm gonna go check things out.
Just don't get too nosy. These kinds of people are usually pretty protective of their privacy.
Yeah, and we don't need you poking your nose where it don't belong and getting us thrown out in our asses.
Hey, Clem, do you like the swing?
Yeah, it's fun.
Be sure to tell Andy thank you, okay?
I will. Will you push me on it?
Sure. Happy to push you on the swing. Mind if Clementine takes a turn?
All right, Duck. Let Clementine have a try for a bit.
Okay.
think of the dairy?
It's pretty. It reminds me of how things used to look before.
Yeah, it does.
Do you think things will ever get back to how they were?
I'm not sure, Clem. I hope so.
I hope so, too.
All right, Clem. That's enough for now.
Okay. Thanks for pushing me.
Of course. It's all yours.
Yeah!
Okay, Duck. Don't pop a gasket.
They look happy.
Hey, Lee. How's it going with the St. John's?
Good. I was talking to Andy earlier and offered our group's assistance on the dairy. I don't think they have much to protect them besides the fence, though he seemed pretty appreciative.
Great. Sounds like they're starting to accept us.
Definitely. How you holding up?
I hope they feed us, Lee. Soon. On the way over here, I was getting dizzy. Hands shaking, cold sweats. Thought I was gonna pass out.
They've got food here.
Yeah. But I'm not just talking about one meal, you know?
I guess, Lily isn't too thrilled about being here.
I could give two shits about what Lily wants. Duck and Katja need food, and I'm not about to sit around that motor inn and watch them go hungry. You're with me on this, right?
Yeah, of course. Lily's judgment is clouded, but you've got a pretty clear head about these things. I'm gonna go have a look around.
Don't wait too long to help scope out that bandit camp. Sounds like they're pretty amped up about it. This might be a good way to earn their trust.
Good idea.
How you feeling, Lee? Look, I'm really sorry you almost got killed out there. We should have told you how dangerous it was.
No shit.
You saw what they did to your buddy. Nobody's safe here until we start to fight back.
But how?
The two of us should go out and do some recon. Then we'll all mount up for some revenge.
Hell yeah.
Who the fuck are these people in the woods?
We don't know. I think some of them used to work at the big box up the way.
Save lots.
Yeah. Anyway, they're nutty as all hell and get mad when they're hungry.
So, are you ready to head out there and find their camp?
Yeah, we gotta work together on this. Those bandits are a danger to everybody. Let's do it.
I'll stay here and hold down the fort.
Remember, we're just doing reconnaissance for now. No use getting ourselves killed. See anything?
Not yet.
I know it's around here. It's gotta be close.
Here.
Oh shit, you found it? See anybody?
Stay on your guard.
Watch my back, Lee. I'm gonna check out the tent.
camp's too small. It can't be their main base.
That's what I was thinking.
Take a look around anyway. There's probably some shit around here they stole from us.
Nothing. Empty. Looks like they expected to be here a while. Tent looks pretty new. Anybody inside?
Two sleeping bags. One of them's kid-sized.
Looks like they were moving a lot of stuff.
What's in the boxes?
They're all from Save Lots.
The first few days, they told folks to gather to the Save Lots by the interstate. Anything worth taking?
This is too much stuff for just one person.
Trust me, these selfish bastards don't stop taking. Probably just to remind us that it's theirs.
Boxes from the dairy here.
Probably the food we've been giving them. Fuckers cross the line. What do you find?
A video camera.
Let me see that.
Battery's dead, though.
Oh, good. What else they got over here? Let's see if we can find anything useful and then get a move on. I see you handled that gun I lent you pretty well. You a hunter?
No, but Lily keeps us all on a regular training schedule.
Lily, right. You did say she was running things for you. Sounds like you picked a good leader.
Empty, but it looks like someone's been eating out of these recently.
Put your guns down.
I ain't going back. You tell him Jolene ain't going back.
Hey, we had a deal. No shooting as long as we gave you food. What the fuck happened?
You had a deal with them. I ain't them. Oh, I know you. I know what you are. And I know what you do.
You don't know me.
Steal my shit. Steal everything from me.
We had a deal. You people broke it first.
We're looking for the people who attacked the dairy and shot my friend.
I don't know where they are, but they ain't here. So get the fuck out of my camp.
She's lying, Lee.
Now, maybe you didn't hear me last time when I asked you, sweet, put your damn guns down. You think I won't kill you? I'm gonna take this here crossbow and put a nice sharp arrow right through your eyeball, into your goddamn brain. You're not men.
You're monsters. All men are monsters. Take what they want and then destroy it all. Take a can of beans. Take a little girl. It's all the fucking same to you.
Screw this.
Y'all wave them guns like you're looking to die.
Shit. What the hell'd you do that for? We had a deal with them.
She was about to shoot us both.
You could have just taken her down. You didn't have to kill her. I mean, I know she was crazy, but damn. It's a clean shot, though. Right through the forehead. That's good shooting right there. Still, what a waste.
So, that's it. We going back?
If they ain't here, I don't know where they are. And it ain't a good idea to go tromping through the woods looking for them. So yeah, we head back. Once they see this, they'll get the message. That was a hell of a ride, huh?
What?
You were a madman back there. Took that crazy bitch down.
You're back! What happened?
Lee took care of it.
This isn't what Terry would have wanted.
Terry?
My husband. Miss him every day.
Then screw it up for everybody then, why don't you?
Oh, calm down, princess. I'll do it.